How were the two candidates you interviewed? Yeah, you know, honestly, both were really great candidates, but there were some things that stood out to me for both of them. One though being the number two candidate, I think I'm gonna go with them because they had way more certifications on their resume than candidate number one. Do you have a deciding factor between the two? They both seem to have really great knowledge and skills. Yeah, honestly, it's not even about, you know, having the number of certifications you have, but more so showing that you're willing to take initiative. They're continuing to learn and grow their skills, and it looks better for the company to hire someone with more certifications, more qualified. Yeah, it makes sense. And also too, it just shows that you're more dedicated and willing to continue to level up. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the top 10 tech certifications for 2024. We are going to dive into a variety of different areas of certification. So if you are someone who might not be 100% certain as to where you want to take your career in the next year, this video is for you. You want to level up, stand out from the crowd, and gain a really interesting certification. All right, let's get into it. Now coming in at number one, can you guess what it is? I feel like it's been in the number one spot for quite a while now, or a few years anyways. Of course, it's AWS, that's your hint. AWS Certified Solutions Architect, the professional certification. Earlier on in this video, we spoke about the associate one. After you have completed that, the next step is the professional. This really has become the gold standard for engineers who want to design and deploy architecture on Amazon's public cloud. And as we know, so many companies are utilizing AWS and Amazon. It's one of those things that if you are looking for a certification that guarantees you a way to level up or stand out from the crowd, you know this certification is exactly that. Now, what's required to take the certification? Well, for one, you need at least 2 years of working experience with AWS. Other things that are required, you must know at least one scripting language, have expertise in AWS APIs and consoles, and also too, a familiarity with both Linux and Windows. There are more prerequisites to this one, as expected with a number one spot. However, you do earn a very nice salary with this, on average around 170 US, which is around 13 to 15,000 more than the average earnings of an associate certificate holder. So, number one spot, not only for it being more in demand, but also too because of you will guarantee a very good compensation, not just based on the certification, but also to your experience you have in achieving that certification. Coming in at number two is Certified Ethical Hacker. And this is an area that I always fantasize about, well, I wonder if I did this certification or, you know, different. There's so many different opportunities in tech. And then even making this list and doing my research, I always get excited about, should I go down this path or should I focus on the cloud? And it's one of those things that is easy to do because there are so many great opportunities. And I'm sure many of you have felt this way as well, where it's almost like, I want to do everything, and in turn, I don't know exactly where to start. Coming in at number three is CISM, or Certified Information Security Manager. This actually used to hold, this certification used to hold number one or number two for many years, quite a few years back actually, but it's still in the top 10. And I think this is because it's really fallen a little bit behind some of its rival certifications, the CISSP, and also to the CRISC certifications, other security certifications. However, I really wanted to include it in this list for two reasons. One, because I didn't want to make this entire list, you know, some of the top popular security certifications, but include other ones as well that maybe you haven't heard about but are very high in demand. Now, for this certification, your job is essentially to design and engineer security protocols and also to manage a company's overall IT security. So it's a pretty big job. Now, according to Skillsoft, CISMs are really well paid. You can make an average of $162,000 a year US. The Cisco Certified DevNet Professional Certification. And I really like actually on their website, they have a really good chart that kind of explains the knowledge domains, recommended experience, and also supported job roles. So if you're interested in this certification, I'll link it down below. I'll link it all down below so you can really go check each one out. So for example, in knowledge domains, 20% software dev, 20% understanding and using APIs, 20% Cisco platform. So it's pretty evenly spaced out that you don't necessarily need to be 100% expert in software development or 100% expert in using APIs, but have a solid understanding of these different areas. For levels of experience, I think this is a really good one too if you are earlier out in your career. 3 to 5 years of experience designing and implementing applications that are built on top of Cisco platforms with experience in Python. So earlier on in your career, meaning even if you are just under the 3-year experience level, it's something to really start looking into. This is a great certification for anyone who is looking to build with Cisco platforms, but also to get into the DevOps space. So when I'm looking up salary for this one, obviously there isn't a specific one for Cisco, but let's go by DevOps because that's kind of the umbrella of what this certification offers. Now on Levels FYI for DevOps, the medium total comp salary in US is $145,000, which sounds right to me. And you know, it's one of those things that having more certifications and experience combined will really help that grow up. Grow up, go up. Coming in at number five, wait, why do I look different? Like this is filmed another day. Because as I was uploading these videos, I realized I missed doing number five and it was too good that I needed to ensure to include it. Coming in at number five is Microsoft Certified Azure Solutions Architect Expert. I have up here on screen the Microsoft website that goes through what is required in this certification. One thing you can see on the site that it says is, as a solutions architect, you have subject matter expertise in designing cloud and hybrid solutions that run on Azure. Some things include compute, network, storage, monitoring, and security. Now, there are some prerequisites for this course. Some of them could be Azure Administrator Associate, or another one could be designing Microsoft Azure Infrastructure Solutions. So this isn't a certification that you can take without these prerequisites, but it is definitely something to work towards, and even starting with one of the other ones they offer and working your way towards this. All right, so what kind of salary can you expect with this certification? Well, this one was not on Levels FYI, so what I did is found one on ZipRecruiter. The average salary of Azure Solutions Architects in the US is $152,000, and this can definitely go up once again based on years of experience and so many other factors. So take this with a grain of salt, but it's definitely something to work towards. Coming in at number six is Google Professional Certified Cloud Architect. Wait, did I get that right? Google Certified Professional Cloud Architect. These certifications, I tell you, they are mouthfuls, but nonetheless, they are so important. One thing I noticed when I was doing a lot of research on in-demand certifications for 2024 was the need for really three areas, let me rephrase that. One being cloud, the other being data, and the third being security. Now there are some other certifications that are in the mix between that we speak about, but those are the three main areas I have seen so far. And I think it's interesting because one of the things I was expecting to see is more certifications around artificial intelligence as AI continues to really skyrocket. However, I do think a lot of these certifications can be applied to specific industries such as AI. Professionals with a certification are valued for their ability to design, manage, and create and secure scalable solutions for Google Cloud. Now, it's important to note, although this is Google Cloud related, one of the things that gaining these certifications does is even if you end up working for a company that does not use Google Cloud specifically, it shows that you are capable of leveling up, taking a course, and getting certifications. So don't let that stop you as to, I'm so stuck between something on Amazon or Google, I don't know which one to take. At the end of the day, yes, you may need to take another certification, but that won't be necessarily a make or break for a company hiring you. All right, because I'm trying to stay consistent, I'm on Levels FYI and they don't have one for specifically Google Cloud Architect. So let's use Solution Architect Salary just to get a rough overview. The medium total comp in US is $189,000, which seems pretty accurate to me. And I think the more specialized you are, this number could really go up. Coming in at number seven, it wouldn't be a list if we didn't include some AWS courses or certifications. And that's because they really are the golden standard, especially when it comes to anything Solutions Architect related or cloud related. Number seven is AWS Certified Solutions Architect, the Associate version. Now, this certification will really test your knowledge and expertise in designing systems on the AWS cloud. For this certification, AWS recommends at least a year of hands-on experience, so it's one of those certifications that you actually don't need to have, you know, 5+ years of experience. You can really start diving in today. This exam takes around 80 minutes and is administered at PSI centers across the US. Now, one of the things I really love about the AWS certifications is there is so many resources online to really start leveling up your skills and learning and studying. I mean, there are so many study groups online to study for these courses and certifications because it is so popular. Now, online here, it says AWS Certified Solutions Architects make an average of $155,000 per year. Now, this might require you to have a bit more experience than 1 year on your resume. However, it is definitely something to work towards. Coming in at number eight is for all you project managers out there, or maybe you are a developer looking to grow into a project management role. You can guess what exam it is. This one's been around for a while and is just continuing to be updated, which is PMP. Project Management PMP? What is this? Project management professional, because that's what you're gonna become. In 2024, there's a lot of talk of new technology coming out and how to really upskill the technical side, but we often forget we need project managers to support these projects, to keep them moving forward, support the team members, and getting this certification isn't necessarily a requirement for a project manager. However, I have seen as this space becomes more and more competitive, the need to really stand out with a certification like PMP. Now, what is the average salary for someone with a PMP certification for a project manager? Well, once again, on Levels FYI, the median total comp for US is $132,000. Now, once again, I could say this for every role, so I promise you I won't, but at the end of the day, it really comes back to the experience you have, not just about the certification. And I know, for me anyways, when speaking to project managers, this seems definitely on the low end for total comp. Coming in at number 9 is CISSP, and on some lists this was ranked even lower, a lot of lists it was ranked higher, so I thought, you know what, based on the other ones that are coming up, this is where it's going to go. Certified Information System Security Professional. Now, what does this individual do? Well, first of all, on many of these lists, it's ranked as one of the best first certifications to take. So if you haven't taken too many certifications in the past and you're looking to level up, especially in the area of security, this could be a very good first certification. This certification was created by the International Information System Security Certification Consortium. That is a mouthful. This certification teaches you how to be information assurance pros. So people who are usually responsible for determining the security aspects of an IT organization's overall architecture, controls, and management. So if you are interested in really leveling up your security skills and moving your career in that direction, this is a great certification for you. And this certification continues to grow closer to number one each year, at least for the past few years, because security is one of those areas that is continuing to grow in demand. I mean, we see all the time on the news or social media, the hackings that are happening around the world, a lot of times at these major companies. And it's these big companies who will pay a premium to have people who have taken these certifications and have expertise in these skills. Now, on average, you have to have a minimum of 5 years worth of relevant experience for this certification. And based on that, you can expect an average compensation of around $160,000 US per year. Now, it's one of those things that it really depends on the size of company you work for and exactly how many years of experience you have. Coming in at number 10 on the list is Certified Data Professional, or CDP. In 2024, one thing that will remain the same, or if anything, continue to increase, is the demand for experts in data. Data is, I mean, we've heard it so many times before, the new oil, or at this point, maybe it's the old oil for how frequent that's been said. Now, within this credential, there are many different job roles that can be filled, from business analytics, data governance, the list goes on. I'm on their website here, and there is a ton of different options. Now, this requires for the assistant certified data professional exam, it requires two exams, one 60-minute foundation data management exam, and a 60-minute foundation information systems core exam. Both of these exams have to be passed at 50% or higher. Now, what type of salary can you expect with this certification? Well, let's pause there for a second. Before I even share that information, I want to make one thing clear. No matter how many certifications you take, it doesn't automatically equate to the salary you will have. It takes years of experience. It takes real world applications. It's not as though you can just go out and get a certification and the next thing you know, you're a millionaire. However, having these certifications really will help you stand out from so many others who are applying for roles, or if you're working on, say, a promotion, standing out from the crowd. Now, as I mentioned, there are a ton of different roles that entail data. So let's start with data. Let's go to Levels FYI. So for data scientists, the median total comp in US is $160,000. Now, once again, if you scroll down on Levels FYI, you can see that this salary really increases depending on how many years of experience you have. All right, those are my top 10 tech certifications for 2024. Listen, there are so many certifications out there. You could say, Tiff, you didn't include this one, or why didn't you add this one? That at the end of the day, I really wanted to make a list that would satisfy many different roles. This isn't the top tech certification list for security or for cloud architects. I wanted to make one that had a bit of everything. So if you are someone who's watching this and you might not be 100% certain as to what's out there or what area you want to specialize in, this will give you a good overview of the different options out there. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you can hear some digging in the background. Mr. Muggs is making himself comfy. But make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, and career-related videos. Leave in the comments what certifications you are interested in. And all right, everyone, I'll see you soon. Thanks.